Hey guys, today we have a 2004 Toyota Tacoma in the shop, and these are super reliable trucks, love them to death, but we have a problem that we keep coming across now. So this customer had a sound system in their vehicle and they lost the whole left side. We got back the front left driver's side, mainly because our head unit went bad, but we're trying to figure out what's going with the rear left or the rear driver's speaker. So we took it apart, we took a tone generator to it. This speaker does produce sound. We're inspecting it, but we have an open circuit up front by the head unit. Upon closer inspection, I always like to check the door boots because these doors open quite wide on these trucks. So upon closer inspection, we took apart the boot and you can see here, this line just broke right off. And there's actually a couple other wires in here that are starting to break. So we're going to extend them just a little bit so they have more slack so we can avoid having any further issues with the power windows and everything else. You can see upon closer inspection, you can see how it's tearing away at all of them. So this one's tearing, that one. So we're gonna try to see if we can reposition this a little bit closer in here so when they open the door, it's not pulling at the wires so hard and creating this issue. Luckily they didn't short anything out or blow any fuses when they're rolling the windows up and down or operating the locks, but you can see that if we don't address this now, it's gonna be very hard to diagnose later on for other shops, and they're gonna have issues. I would hate for this to happen where a wire chafes, you pop a fuse and it's raining, like it wasn't raining, had the windows down, it starts to rain, and all of a sudden you can't roll your windows up. Like who cares, if the speaker doesn't work, not a big deal, but if you can't roll your windows up, and it starts to rain, that's gonna be very difficult. You'd have to take apart the door and get to the motor and then power it up separately, and who has time for that if you're in the middle of nowhere? Upon closer inspection, I don't think the harness is too short, but you can see there's double steel here. And what I think is happening, I think the factory wires are chafing on this inner piece over here. So I'm gonna do one thing to help stop that. I've placed some lume in here, so hopefully now when it opens and closes, when it's pulling on it, it stops chafing on here. I don't think it's gonna chafe on the outer one because the boot's over on this side and helps grommet it. But I think Toyota needed to put this on this side to help stop this problem. Okay, we've done our repair, so this is what it looks like. We soldered and shrink tube everything, and I'm using interior Tessa. What I find with this type of tape, as long as it doesn't get wet, so because it's going further in there, I don't think it's going to get wet, but this stuff is really hard to tear, and that's what I want in this location. So with having the lume on the metal and this type of tape should prevent the problem from ever happening again. And then we're going to go ahead and tape this over here as well so we don't notice anything, and that way the wire can move freely. With our repairs complete, the factory boots all the way back in, it's like we were never there. So yeah guys, make sure you always double check your door boots when you're trying to examine why a speaker isn't working. In this case, it was a problem on top of a problem, so our driver, the whole left side didn't work. We were able to get the front working, this side didn't work because we had a break in the line. It is possible that this shorting out might have damaged the left channel on the head unit. Usually that's really rare. Head units that are aftermarket typically will go into protection mode. This one, it's hard to say what happened to it. I inspected the right side, the passenger side, and the rear. There was no chafing, so we just taped it up. We put some lume in there just to do some preventative maintenance. But if you guys have these Tacomas, double check your boots here and see if you're having a chafing issue, and then just go ahead and repair it, and you shouldn't have any issues in the future. If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button, and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way at all times you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section and it keeps applying it to different vehicles. Yeah.